She began this practice essentially with 12 hippies, to be very honest. And since that time, Sahaja Yoga has spread to over 42 countries worldwide, including Russia, Bulgaria, and many other.
पर्स में से है हमारे लाल वाला ये है जैसे अच्छा
I've been coming to San Diego since long. The first time I remember when I came here, it was in the year 1973. And for 9 years I did not come here, I must say. I felt that the name of the place means that this is the city of God, Dio means God. But that time people were involved into things which were not reality at all. And I thought that let them pass through this circle, otherwise they won't come to reality. And for 9 years I didn't come to America. The human problem is on one side that we are seeking something and we are realizing that we have not found the reality. That's a fact. So we try every sort of thing. We try because we are seeking something. But what are we seeking? What is the truth? People may say, this is the truth, that is the truth. And also you'll find people identified with wrong things, identified with destructive things, and they stick on to it. So first of all, we have to know what is the truth. When we talk of truth, they should really tell us what is the truth. The truth is that you are a spirit. You are not this body. You are not this mind. You are not your imagination or your emotions, but you are the spirit, because you always say, my thoughts, my emotions, my ego. You never say, I, the ego. So the ego and the conditionings and all these things are not yourself. So you have to be the spirit. And all the scriptures have said this. First thing, you have to be the spirit is the first truth. And the second is that there is the all-pervading power, which is a subtle power which does all the living things. We take it for granted. For example, we see the flowers, we take them for granted. We don't see that yesterday they were just plants. And we don't see these plants yesterday were just seeds. How this living thing has happened? The science says that we were amoeba and today we are human beings. Now what has worked it out? When we go into the deeper investigation of these things, we reach a point where we think it's blank. How these things are working out? What is working it out? So the second truth is that there is a subtle power that does all this organization. Now when I'm talking to you about it, you have to have an open mind of a scientist. If you are already conditioned with something else, it won't be understood. But if you just have an open mind as a scientist and an honesty about it, then you should treat it as a hypothesis. And then if you find it, that's the truth, then you must accept and go deep into it. Because that is what is what you are seeking, that is what where you have to ascend, that is where you have to become that superior personality, and that is what is the breakthrough of your evolution. Then you must open your mind to it first of all. America is not such a closed heart as English are, I would say. But minds are closed. While the English have closed hearts, but minds are open. It's a little funny combination. But the English have one good thing about them, that if they find something as the truth, they get at it. I've been many more times, I mean, in here, and I've been every year coming, but I find that in England, people worked it out very thoroughly. Even very, very ordinary people who came to Sahaja Yoga, not necessarily all of them were scholars, have mastered Sahaja Yoga. They are not frivolous at all, never. They are very serious-minded people. And they will not waste their energy into stupid things, that's true. But they can be fooled very easily. If somebody tries to say big things to them, say a Sanskrit scholar comes in, then they get enamored. And in America I've found that people are very vulnerable because they were so simple, very vulnerable to the show, to the advertisement and things like that. You see, it's not a showmanship in Sahaja Yoga. It's something to become. It's the becoming that is important. What have you become? Now, various people ask me thousands of questions about this guru, that guru. I said, first of all, you must go and see the disciples. Now look at Graham, you see him. There are thousands like these. What have they got? Nothing. Bankruptcy, most of them. They have become recluses, they have become mad, they have got sickness. This is not what is promised. Or they are crazy, they can't explain anything. So what have they got? First, they must have the power, and the power of love that can raise the kundalini is written in all the scriptures whatsoever in different ways, in different styles. For in every religion, whether it talks of God or not, there are some religions who do not talk of God, like Buddhism, Jainism, Hindu, certain types of Hinduism, or also you can say Islam, in a way, talks of a formless God, more of formless. Jewish also talk of formless God. But there's one thing common among all of them is this, that seek the eternal. And whatever is transitory, you treat it with all wisdom and understanding and limitations of that transitory things. But we are so much enamored because we are seeking. In America, the seeking is frantic, actually. It's a panicky stuff. It is so frantic that in their seeking only they got into troubles. In their seeking, blindly they fell into drugs and AIDS and everything. Only in their seeking. It was not because they wanted to be bad. It was not that they wanted to be sick. It was not that they wanted to take to drugs. But they were vulnerable, very simple people, and fell attracted to it. I mean, if you see it now after Sahaja Yoga, people see it and they are surprised how we were enamored by these things. They are very, very simple people, extremely simple. I think they are the simplest in the whole world. Even the South Americans are quite, they think about it. They worry about it, find out. It's all right or not. They will not jump to any conclusions. They are quite cautious by nature, very cautious. They will not jump into problems till they have verified and found out. So one thing I must warn you, that you must verify, first of all, what are we seeking? And you must judge it from the disciples or from the people who claim to be following a certain thing. Now, you may be thinking about religions, but there are many who have felt that religions are the most misleading things. Now, how do you make Christ and Christianity together? And people think if Christianity means all this nonsense that people did, is to take a gun in one hand and a Bible in another hand, then how is it Christ who said, forgive those who are doing wrong things on the cross? How could that be valid? So actually it can be very easily understood if you understand Sahaja Yoga. That unless and until you united with the reality, you go on drifting onto left or the right side. Now, as he must have told you here about the parasympathetic nervous system, we have two other systems which are working within us in autonomous nervous system, the left and the right side. Now, those who go to the right side, because they have not ascended, Sahaja Yoga is for your ascent. So what happens, unless and until there is union with that divine power, the yoga, unless and until you are really reborn, not just certified, but really reborn, then you don't move to the left or to the right. But if you start moving to the left, for example, your Pentecostal system, your this charismatic system are all left-sided system, and you get caught up into a very funny system that we call as the collective subconscious mind. Into the collective subconscious mind, you just get possessed, and most of the diseases which we call as psychosomatic come from the left side. AIDS, all these things. The right-sided movement, which is the movement where we plan too much, we are futuristic, we think about money all the time, we can say, or religions which are money-oriented. They take you towards money. So you move to your right. And when you start moving to your right too much, then you start using your conscious mind too much. And this conscious mind gets tired, and that's how you have got this new disease of yuppies, about which the Americans are worried. This yuppies disease comes from this too much futuristic thinking. And I had told about these diseases long time back, but nobody wants to take notice of it. On the other hand, Russians are there, I mean, comparatively. They are the wisest you could think of, wisest people. They wouldn't allow Rajneesh to enter in, they wouldn't allow TM to enter in, they wouldn't allow any one of these. There are certain fundamentalists, but they don't think much of them. 60% people, Russians, are very wise. Now what should we say? I'm myself amazed at them, even their ministers and everybody. Now what I would say that we have so much so-called freedom of choice, and still morning we think, I will eat this, I will eat that. I mean, the attention goes to nonsensical things like that. And they had no choices of any kind. Whatever is available in the market, you have it. If you don't have it, you don't have it. It's like a ship where there are no problems, because nothing. If something is not on the ship, it's not there. So they didn't have to bother about these things, what dress I should wear, what clothes I should wear, what should I eat, where should I go to see this film or that. Whatever is available is here, and that's what it is for. It's like you're bringing up a child in a way that he does not have to bother too much about his choices. Whatever is given, the child takes it. And they were brought up that way. By that, they did develop a kind of a fear. And an awe, I know that. But other faculties they developed within themselves are remarkable. Really remarkable, you won't believe that first of all they do not have class consciousness. You may be the minister of the Supreme Council or you may be a laborer. They all feel the same way. There's no ego at all. No ego of any kind. A Supreme Council fellow will come and behave in this. I would not be able to make them out. He is this or he is that. All dress up very well. All of them have got good clothes. Now the problems have been created, of course, by their bureaucrats artificially because they don't want their power to go away. So they are power-oriented and democracies are all money-oriented. Both things are wrong. We have to be spirit-oriented. But because the money part was missing there and power was in the hands of wrong people and they were frightened of the power, the people there are very alert and extremely wise. The difference is such a lot. Of course, I always feel that Americans are the greatest seekers. They are not such seekers as you are, but they are very wise. There's a difference of attitude. Their attitude is that this is a nice thing, this is the reality, this is what it is, and we should take. They'll discard everything, discard religion, discard everything, but they stick on to the reality. And the another one is, they are not seekers as you are. You are seekers of truth, no doubt. But in seekers of truth, if you do not have discrimination to know what is the reality, you fall prey. And you'll be surprised that I have seen that most of the people who have suffered from these diseases have been to some guru or to some false person. Now, today there have been so many questioning like that. I said, I don't want to say things that do not exist, but what exists within us is too much of an anxiety to seek the truth. But because we do not know what is the truth and how to judge it, we go into problem. Now this system that is within us is to be known actually after self-realization according to Vedas. Veda means also to know. Know on your central nervous system is Vedas. Bodha, which Buddha is, also means on your central nervous system, not mentally. It's beyond mental. All these people, whosoever whom we call as the originator of religions and all that, have said the same thing, that you have to know yourself, know thyself. Now, which religions are doing that? So these are no religions. These are man-made ideas. And that's why we are misled. But this is not going to be for our benevolence, for our ascent, for our last breakthrough into that higher state about which people have talked. So then we should give up. This is not the thing. What is the reality? Let's go to the reality. Then another point which is very shocking, I mean, in England, I don't know, Graham has told you or not, that the BBC people approached me and they said, how is it you say you don't have to pay? Anglo-Saxon brain cannot understand anything without money. Can you imagine? Can you purchase God? Can you purchase divinity? How much did you pay to Christ? You are all supposed to be Christian people. How much did we pay to Christ? How can you pay for it? How much do we pay for our living work? Ask such a question. And this is the thing which has struck them the best, the Russians. You can't pay. We have not paid for our evolution. We have not paid for the living process. Then how can you pay for the last breakthrough? But here people always told me, you have to ask for money. Otherwise, Sahaja Yoga won't grow in America. I said, how much are they going to pay for it? First of all, you make it up. How much are we going to pay? When I say you cannot pay, you must understand it, that it is beyond materialism. It is beyond all these things that you have to achieve. And on that point, it falters, which I think you please, all of you who are here today, have to think about it seriously. It's not a frivolous game we are playing. It's not that something we are doing so stupidly about things which are so important to us. If you have to save this America, you must get people realized. Deep people. I must say that this triggering has happened because we got these people realized. Very few of them had come to a conference where I was. They all got realization, they went back, within 8 days it started working. It's a fact. Everyone knows that. Everyone knows that it has happened that way. But that kind of a depth, that kind of an understanding and discrimination we must have. We must see for ourselves, ask ourselves the questions, is this the reality? Also, Sahaja Yoga, I would say you should be cautious and see for yourself, is this the reality? You should not be judged because Sahaja Yoga opens doors to everyone. So you should not be judged by stupid people if they come to Sahaja Yoga. It's all right, everybody is welcome. But you must see, what did I get out of it? What is, I would say as a mother, what was your gain? Selfishness. Let's see selfishness. What did you get out of Sahaja Yoga? Why are you there? What did you get anywhere else? And don't be under delusion, please. I have told many a times, this country is so great. There are so many saints born here who were seekings before also. But they are so much misled by this advertisement, these artificialities, superficialities, and materialism, the worst of all. That it might be destroyed from outside, as they say, but most probably it will be destroyed from inside. And that's what is happening. So you have to, if you have the freedom, you must have freedom to think and to think wisely, to think with discrimination. This is what, as a mother, I would say. As a mother, I feel, what have you gained? You've got horrible people here, you paid them money, you had such hypocrites and horrible people who looted you, exploited you, like simple children. And now, beware, be careful. And come up to the reality. Ask for reality. In Sahaja Yoga we have no organization, we have no membership, we have, as I told you, nothing of the kind. But you have to become. You have to become something. A state has to be achieved. And that is what is the most important thing. Just like you come to my lecture, then go to another lecture, go to another lecture. It's useless, I tell you. Is absolutely useless. And there must be some people who are of that depth, I'm sure among you, who can trigger so many things for this country. And if you have any patriotism or any feeling for the betterment and benevolence of your people, you must take to Sahaja Yoga in a serious way. It's not a joke. It's not something stupid like people start dancing, saying Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. It's not like that. That anybody can do. Your kundalini has to rise and you have to feel that cool breeze all around you, which is described so clearly. It is my heartfelt desire that this country should be saved. It's a very important country in the universe. And not only that, but it has another great, great responsibility that it has to communicate. Communication power is the maximum here. Later on in Sahaja Yoga, you will know how important is America. Many people have been telling me that, Mother, why do you go to America? We have the least number of Sahaja Yogis among all the 40 nations. Even in Turkey, we have more Sahaja Yogis. So why do you want to go to that country and waste your time unnecessarily? Because as it is, you have to travel so much. Because I know the potential. I don't know how to awaken that potential in people that they understand it. It helps in every way. How it helps you, that I'll tell you tomorrow. And how it cures you, that also I'll tell you tomorrow. But in this country you can't even cure anyone. You can't do anything. You'll have to come to England if you have to get cured. In England there's no problem. Doesn't matter. What is important is that first of all, you become something. That's all. Nothing else is needed. You have to become something. You don't become mad, you don't become a recluse, you don't become crazy, you don't become like a stupid fool, but you become knowledgeable to begin with. Then you become powerful. And thirdly, you are completely above everything. You become righteous, you become a witness, you become whatever is said about a saint. You become a saint and you don't have to give up anything, don't have to give up your families, nothing, all this is nonsensical. So, it is my humble request to all of you who are here, which are very few in number. I mean, if you, Russia, first time I went to Leningrad, the hall was only for 2,000 people and 2,000 people were outside, first time. They had never heard my name, nothing, I don't know, from my photograph or whatever their wisdom was. So when I went in, They said, that learned the word Ma from someone. Ma, what about us? What about us? I felt so sad. I said, I can't take them. So I was sitting inside, I gave them realization. Everybody got realization. When I went out, 2,000 were sitting outside, still. I said, now what to do? I said, tomorrow you come in this open space, tomorrow morning I'll be here. I went there, the 2,000 inside and 2,000 inside, outside, all were there. It has spread like fire there, just like fire. While here, I don't know what's going to happen. We'll have diseases after diseases. What's going to happen to our country? And today I wanted to warn you, really, because I came here for the first time. First time I came to America. I knew that people are seeking, but they were already lost. Lost to stupid shows, very stupid shows. I must say that is very important. I have a special feeling for San Diego, and I think you will all appreciate and understand your responsibility. Tomorrow I'll explain to you how this Kundalini, which is your own power, it has nothing to do with me in a way, because you yourself get your own power, and that you know about it because you become aware of it. You work it out on your own. But you have to be deeper, and you must have a deeper movement into it. It's not something frivolous. It's not something that you can do this and do that. You have to go deep into it. And if you touch your depth, then you'll find that you will become such a dynamic person, very dynamic, and at the same time very compassionate. I have such a concern, very great concern for America. And we have to understand that we are the people who are not very successful, because success goes into ego, not in Russia, here. Here success goes into the ego of people. So the so-called successful, the so-called very rich and all that, I don't have much hopes from them. They'll destroy themselves all the time by their ego or by their wrongdoings as they are doing it. But those who are sensible, wise, should take it up seriously. I hope next time when I come, I'll find more Sahayogis here than we have now. Surprisingly, he told me there are only 100 Sahayogis in the whole of America. While, I mean, even in Australia, we have in thousands. Just can't understand. Is it that we are going to depend on these entrepreneurs who are trying to befool us, or we are going to have our own personality and our own knowledge, our own capacity? Everybody has to become a guru. You are not to depend on anyone. You have to depend on yourself, on your own knowledge, on your own capacities. You are no less than anybody else. You all have these powers. Only thing, these are to be awakened and to be developed. I would of course like to have some questions from you today. Then tomorrow I won't be asking questions, but I would like to meet you all individually. I did that last time, but they are all lost people again. It's just, I think, like a social event, it is not so. This is your identity, that you work for God. You don't work for yourself. This is how you find your identity, not by joining some sort of a cult or joining some sort of a funny, crazy thing. Your identity is that you are responsible for God's work in reality, in understanding. I would like to have your questions. If you write them, it will be better. If you can write them and ask me questions, it would be much better. Because I must say, I would understand it better if you write it and then give me.
If you could please just write your questions down on a piece of paper. We've got some ushers that are going to be coming from the back. If you don't have a paper or something to write with, they have one with them, and you can just dictate to them what you'd like to ask, that you want to do.
Or you can, they can come and ask one or two questions verbally also. But all right, come along. You ask. You tell him the question, because this is difficult. What a nice question. Beautiful. Thank you very much for such a nice question. So very happy to hear such a nice question. Now, we have a center here. We have an ashrami. We have some very good Sahaja Yogis also, very well equipped, who are anxious to help you. We have. So you have to just get the address. You can always telephone, meet them and develop it. Another very wise people in this country are Chinese. I was surprised. Not Indians. No, not Indians. And Indians who have come to America are very different type. I don't know who they are. I always say that if you bring a mango tree from India, it won't even produce an apple sort of a thing it is. But Chinese are. I'm surprised they have kept their wisdom intact. Chinese are very good. And if we have 100 Sahaja Yogis, out of them at least 25% are Chinese.
For those of you that have come, there will be follow-up meetings in Balboa Park starting next week, Thursday evening at 7:30 p.m. in the Café de Leonardo in the La Sala room. They will be weekly thereafter. Every week at Thursday, on Thursday at 7:30 p.m. they'll be there. Also, when you leave tonight, we'll have little packets of information at the table to lead to the entries that you can pick up and take with you. They'll tell you a little bit more about Sahaja Yoga and also when the meeting times are.
I'll ask you. It's my turn.
I was speaking to a Sahaja Yogi about...
Acha, you read it out and give it to me.
This person was speaking to a Sahaja Yogi about the receptivity of the Russian people. In just a few short months, to Sahaja Yogi, to Sahaja Yoga, and they were wondering why the same response is not here.
What is it about? I was speaking to a Sahaja Yogi about the
receptivity
of the Russian people to Sahaja Yoga. Is
in just a few short months.
Why is there not
the same response?
You see, just see, I've answered this question already. I'm sorry, but I've already answered this question. Just imagine. That he's asking how is it that Russians are so receptive and we are not. I mean, it's a question that we should find out the reality, discard everything else. In Sanskrit it's a saying, yan neti neti vachanairi nigamo avachus. Kaun saying, not this, not this, not this. Then you reach the right part, all right? You go on saying, this is not true. This is not. Because we have paid it, we have to go through it. You see, this is the problem is. If you go and see a play, supposing we paid for the ticket, we say, now if you've seen, it may be the worst play, but you go through it because you have paid for it. So you have paid for it, you paid for all this nonsense, so you go through it. And when you go through it, you get into troubles. That's the problem is.
Srimadhi, this question is, what is Shaktipat Kundalini and how does it work? So many are claiming expertise in Kundalini, how do we distinguish
a real teacher from a false one? Yeah. You see, it is, I came here in I told you, I was 73. And I gave lectures everywhere. There was one Dr. Chaudhary who was the one who was organizing my programs. And he told me, Mother, you better make it a, what you call that? Copyright. Make a copyright of it. I laughed at him. I said, what is the copyright? He said, a copyright is that nobody can use your words. And I said, it's all right, let them use, I'm very happy. And if they can do it, even I'll be happier. You see, because after all, it's a very great thing. But you see, actually there's no copyright about it. You have to do it. You have to work it out. How can there be a copyright? So they picked up all these words and you see, they built up all these organizations. This one gentleman who has also got a Sahaja Yoga. And he came to Sahaja Yoga first and now he's making a big money out of it. He's making big money. And he came to see me and I told him, why are you making big money out of Sahaja Yoga? You can't. How much did you pay me? So he said, no, because Americans don't understand money. I said, it is Americans or you? And he's really made such a lot of money, you have no idea. And he's supposed to be teaching Sahaja Yoga only. So anybody who asks for money, you should know it's not Sahaja Yoga by any chance. It has nothing to do with divinity. It has nothing to do with reality. First thing, first. It's a very simple thing. 99.9% all of these false people will fall off. You may claim anything, but first of all, what do you get? First question. What do I get? Supposing you go to a shop, all right? You have to buy something. You won't pay for nothing, will you? But here you are paying for sickness, you are paying for craziness, for madness, you are paying for all kinds of bondages. This is ultimate freedom. What's that?
How can the search for the higher self be achieved in less than a second when it seems difficult to reach it in a lifetime? What's next after that? What is the point?
Yes, you have already spent lives. The time has come now to achieve it in a second. It is true that it is difficult. It was difficult. But maybe there's something about me that I'm doing it that fast, isn't it? Like people used to go to any place, say for when they first came to San Diego, how much they must have struggled to come here. But today you just take a plane and you are here. Already there is speed working everywhere, so why not in Sahaja Yoga? Which one? Ah, horrible. Horrible. How? You don't go to anyone who gives diamonds, do you? He distributes diamonds. You can go to the shops and get diamonds. How can you be enamored? That shows materialism, materialistic attitude. I can understand. Some villagers in India go to him because they would say, oh, he gives us time. But he doesn't give to villagers. He gives to very rich people who are crooks already well known in India. I know of a politician who was thrown out, absolutely, as the greatest crook, was one of the greatest followers of this man. If there is somebody who is divine, who is your guru, the divinity must show in your life, in your style, in your method, in your ways, isn't it? You can't be the greatest crook going around as having a guru who gives diamonds. You have to have the diamond, but the diamond of your spirit.
Srimadaji, this person asks, is there an absolute universal truth? Or are there only individual truths, that life in harmony with others, individual truths?
Can I see the question? With this sound around, you know, I can't hear. Is there an absolute
universal truth? Or are there only individual truths, that lie in harmony with other individual truths?
No, it's absolutely an universal truth. It's absolutely universal, and the universal being is your spirit. And is through that you can know the universal truth. Now in Sahaja Yoga, I'll tell you how. Supposing there are 10 children who are realized souls. We have many realized souls now born to Sahaja Yogis. Now you tie their eyes up with some sort of a bandage and make them stand in line. Ask them, what's wrong with this gentleman? Supposing somebody is sitting there. They will all point you out the same finger. Say, supposing they point out this finger to you. So you ask that person, is something wrong with your throat? Yes. How do you know? Because it is on your central nervous system, again I say, that you feel it. Central nervous system. Like you take a dog through a dirty passage or something. He won't mind anything. He won't smell anything. But you take a human being, he won't. So on our central nervous system, we have developed so many capacities. In the same way, when you become realized, then on your central nervous system, a new dimension of awareness comes in, where you become collectively conscious. When you become, again, it is not that we are all one world, we are one human being. It's not that. It's not that. It is you become. So you start feeling another person and you can feel yourself also. That's what it has to come to. And that is what it is, that it is an universal truth. And the universal truth is actually universal love. And the universal love knows all the truth about you. That's what I'm saying is the all-pervading power. And that starts flowing through you. When it starts flowing through you, it gives you the universal truth. We are all universal beings, to be very frank. You see, God has made different countries, different places, just to create variety. If you see in the nature, one leaf will not agree with another. It's to create variety and beauty. He has made America, He has made India and all that. If supposing we were all just the same to look at, we would have looked like Bad Roberts or something like that. Would not have looked beautiful. There would have been no beauty. So He created. But we are the ones who have created so many worlds. It's our mistake. It's our problem. And that's why one has to know that we are all universal being. Within us lies that spirit, which is the universal being. You will be very happy to know that when I went to Russia, 25 Germans came to give them realization. Can you believe that? The Germans came to give them realization. The whole thing was so touching, you know. Even the Russians had tears in their eyes to see the Germans who came all the way to give them realization and to look after them. Now, from where does this transformation come in? And the general, if you see that now the German Sahaja Yogis, they are the most gentle people you could think of, gentlest of gentle. It's very surprising. You won't call them Germans at all, no more. Now this is all.
This person says, from Kundalini, we seek enlightenment. Zen, another way of seeking enlightenment, is there. Are they linked? Sometimes I think I'm starting to see, then it becomes blurry.
Okay. Sorry to see what? Sometimes I think I'm starting to see that it becomes blurry. What becomes blurry?
Seeing the truth.
Acha. Now, the Kundalini is the one that gives you enlightenment. Zen is the same as Kundalini. Zen has not talked of anything else. Tao is the same. Everything is the same in a different way. But in those days it was not so clearly said, because they did not give realization to people. Even the tree of life that is described in the Bible is the same. Even Muhammad Sahib has described, there's a surah called Yasin, means Yoga Sajda. He's given the word Yoga Sajda. And in that he has written that your hands will speak when your resurrection will take place. In all these scriptures they have written. But the thing is that Zen to understand, I met a gentleman who was the head of the Zen who came to India. He got very sick, so nobody could cure him, so they took me down there. So I asked him, how are you head of the Zen? You are not even a realized soul. He said, yes, it's true. Then I said, how are you a Zen head? He said, what to do? I said, why? He said, from 6th century till the 13th century, there were only 26 Kashyapas, means realized souls. After that, there has been no realized soul. So that's how I am the head. Because you can't... But I said, I better give you realization. He said, please do. This is the situation. So, you see, it is not... Before realization you can understand these people. Then you can start seeing them between the lines. Before that, you don't see the subtleties. Then Zen is the same. There's no... Zen means dhyana. Is to be in meditation is Zen.
This person asks, what about Christ, Sri Mataji? What do we have to say about Christ?
Christ. I mean, one has to write a big book about it. Christ is the incarnation of innocence. And to know about him, you have to read some other books also. Because he came on this earth and they just tortured his life. He lived hardly for 4 years with people. And at such a young age, he was crucified. What he said that, I am the Son of God, is a fact. But how will you prove it? How will you prove it? Jews don't believe it, Muslims don't believe it. But now, after coming to Sahaja Yoga, Jews and Muslims all believe it. Because you can find out, on your vibrations, you can find out whether he was the Son of God or not. Where he resides within us is the most important point, the gate. He's the gate. On the Agya Chakra, I'll tell you about that. It's very important. Without Christ, we cannot work it out. He is the gate. Through him you have to pass. But all others are important. All others are important. And he has said it, those who are not against me are with me. And he has also said it, if you have read, in the second chapter of the second verse of Matthew's, he said it, that you will be calling me Christ, Christ, I won't recognize. And all these fundamentalists and all these so-called people who talk of Christ, they are the ones he mentioned. You'll be calling me Christ, Christ, I won't recognize. They are just money makers. You can see them. They're befooling people. All of them, one and all. Even Catholics, I have seen the Pope's things. I mean, I can't believe it. He was worse than Tsar. They have so many things with them, so many, and they're just money-making propositions. The whole organization sits down how to make money like any big business organization. That's all, nothing beyond. Everything is a money-making organization. Somehow it so happened that I came in contact with people who are very close. And you know about so many scandals and things about it. I need not tell you. But it is much worse than that. It's much worse. From India, they got hold of some young girls, brought them, and with force they made them into these sisters, they call them, or you can call them the nuns, kind of nuns. And they just cleaning, sweeping, sobbing, washing. One of them escaped and wrote to Indian government about it. And they had to be rescued, but there are still many lost inside there. Is this the work of God? Has it got something to do with God? I myself was born in a Christian family and I know all their ins and outs very well. This is no Christ, this is not Christianity. They came to our villages with guns in their hands. What about this America? Thank God Columbus came here, otherwise you would not have seen me here. We all Indians would have been finished. Not one person would have been left. You'll be surprised in Argentina and Chile, you can't find one Aboriginal person. Not one. You might find here, but not in Chile or Argentina. All are finished, completely finished and destroyed. Columbus, I don't know, by God's grace came here. Otherwise there would have been no Sahaja either. So this is what it is. To understand all these things, to understand what Christ was and what He is, we have to have our realization. Otherwise, because you are born in a Christian religion, you are a Christian. What is this? You could be born anywhere, in any religion. Just a chance. Sahaja Yoga is not a chance. It's a happening. It's actualization. It's not a chance. So I hope you'll come tomorrow and I'll give you all realization. Today I don't think it is to be done. But tomorrow definitely you call your friends, call them, talk to them what I've told you. Today I've decided that I'll give you realization tomorrow, not today. And tomorrow you should come and get your realization and then I would like to meet all of you. It's a very intimate relationship in the sense that I know your Kundalini. And I know you, what you are, what are your problems. And that's how I will be looking after. I hope you'll understand this. This is not something that you just go to a cinema show or something. It's much deeper and has the real significance in your life. It's for your benevolence, for your protection, for everything. So may God bless you all. May God bless you. So tomorrow I would be here much earlier and I think I'll tell you about the Kundalini as well as I will also give you realization. And actually I told you in Vedas it's written that the yantra, mantra, yantra and tantra, these things are to be told after realization. That is the technique. That is the mantras and also the yantra, means this instrument, is to be described after realization, not before. Because otherwise, as you said it, there are Shaktipat and Kundalini, all these people claiming to be this and that. You see, it's very easy in America to claim anything because people are so simple. I know of two persons who escaped from Indian jails and came here, wore that dress and became great gurus. Really, I tell you, I know their names also. And if they see me, if they know that I'm here, they'll run away. They won't be here nearby anywhere. Yeah, it's true. So many of them have come from India who had nothing to eat, were just leafless people working there. They just came here as gurus because, you see, special category people are allowed in America. This is the special category of thugs. So they come here and nicely settle down. And they have really ruined so many people. I know, I feel very ashamed. If I call myself an Indian, I feel very much ashamed the way they have done it. But you should get yourself all right. You should know that. That's a fact. And I feel sorry for that, but what can we do? I mean, if you get enamored by such stupid people, you should see their lifestyle. You should see their knowledge. You should see the way they are. It is very easy to make out. Very easy to make them out. Very easy. Use little intelligence and little tricks. I don't have to tell you. You can easily bribe them. You see, they can take bribes from you and can say that now, tomorrow you'll go to heaven. They can do that. Telling lies is an art in India, I tell you. I can see from here, such lies. How can they tell? They are not afraid of God. It's an art they have developed in India, really, I tell you. I feel so ashamed. A country where people would never tell a lie, they would never lock their houses. We have become so horrid with these 300 years of slavery. We have become such horrid people there. Don't trust them. I feel sorry, but it is so. What can you do? Now, of course, Sahaja Yoga is taking a big stride in India, very much so. I mean, I never have less than 15,000 to 16,000 people coming to Sahaja Yoga, no doubt. Now it's all right. But I had to first tell them off. I have to give up all these nonsensical ideas of exploiting others. All right, thank you very much. May God bless you all. Hope to see you tomorrow. Now call your friends, telephone to them and get them here. I'm here only for tomorrow.
जब आयको से कहीं ठीक दिसत नाही मला काल तिला झाडली जात दोन दिवस आले का तुम्ही
अंजनी नमस्कार कर
डॉक्टर
बरळीकर नहीं तुम्हें एक काम
बरोबर
आणि आता सगळ्यांना ठीक केलं पाहिजे हा वा किती बरोबर सांगितलं भगवान
नाही तर सगळ्या पुष्कळ मंडळी माणसं रामनवमीचा जन्म यायचा आणि याचा गणेश चतुर्थी
वा 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 आता
बसवा जरा तुला इंडियन लोकांना हिला बसवतो बरेचदा बसते
लोकांना बोलायला पाहिजे तिकडे तो अडाडकर telephone to call and get some more friends because the boys are getting disappointed.